Hey, this is Mike Gingrich with another Live with Mike take two. So for whatever reason, my audio did not take the last time, and I apologize for that. So in the recording, there was nothing, zip, zero. And so when that happens, you gotta do it over, you gotta do it over. So we're going live again. And so this one is not at 12 o'clock hour, it's almost 12:30. But it took me that long to figure things out and make sure my audio was working this time. So I'm back, and today I'm going to talk about five ways to use your web content better. So this is we always talk about the importance of getting new, fresh content out on your website to help you with search engine optimization. Multiple reasons for that, but let's say you got a new blog post and you got it out there, you shared it out, you think you're done. That was the new blog post. But I'm saying there are multiple things you can do with that, and you should do with that, to maximize the use of that, all right? So that's what we're gonna dive into today. Now, first things first though, your personal life tip of the day, and that is, do you have a Teflon coating? A Teflon coating. So in the morning, I make my eggs, and I make them in a Teflon pan. Why do I do that? Because it is a non-stick pan. I can shake them, and it does not stick. That is the goal. And in life, I think that we need to develop the ability to have a Teflon coating. There's going to be situations, there's going to be difficulties, there's going to be challenges in life, and things are going to come at us, situations, people, whatever. And we, if we're going to survive, we're going to thrive, we're going to be able to move on and continue to add value to others, we're going to need to have a Teflon coating. So it is not... you know, it's not forgetting what people have done, but it's choosing to, you know, to move on, to move past it, and to look at the present and future and say, what can I do? What's going to be most beneficial for me to do today and tomorrow and the future going forward? So we have to develop a ability to let things go, and for our own sanity, for our own benefit there. So that's your tip for today. Comes from my leadership book on Add Value, Be Uncommon. Just want to give you that. And the second thing is, very pleased, I'm going to give you the results when I get into a little bit more. But last week, I was on a show, Magnet Marketers, and we had a guest, Dr. Jason Richardson. And this was his book. It's all BS. We're all wrong. You're all right. Now, before you think you know what BS is, this is a little bit of a play on words. And BS in this case is your belief system. So I'm going to dive into this. I'll let you know what I think down the pike there. That's my tips to get us started for today. Now to dive into the topic, the five ways to use your web content. The first one is to create a video from the blog content. Let's say you had five key points that you made. You can make a video about those five key points. Now, at the end of that, I'm going to tell you exactly how to do that, but right now I want to tell you what to do with that. So you've got this video, let's make it 1 minute, okay? Because 1 minute gives us a lot of flexibility on where we can use it. So we've got this 1 minute video. I want to recommend that you load that to YouTube. You should create a YouTube channel, and that should be loaded to YouTube with the title and the description that summarizes the blog post there and the link back to the blog post. So now that video resides on your YouTube channel. In YouTube, you can get embed code, you can grab video, you can place that within the blog post. So now you've added value to the blog post, because hopefully you've got an image in there, but now you've got a video in there as well. Okay, you can share that YouTube video on Twitter. Now, the next thing you want to do is take that same video source file and you want to load that to Facebook, and you want to create a Facebook post with that video in it. And then you want to go to LinkedIn and you want to load that on LinkedIn. And you can also go over to Pinterest and do that there. Now, I am recommending specifically that you do that on Facebook and LinkedIn, because, and don't just share the YouTube video over there, because those platforms both have systems in place that they give better precedence, better reach to the videos that are loaded to their systems natively. So you load it to Facebook, it's gonna get to see more people than if you share a YouTube video there. Same thing for LinkedIn. LinkedIn's working really well with video now, so load that up there and share it, talk about it, ultimately link back to the blog post. So you're getting traffic back to your blog post from the video. So the video post can perform better on those platforms. So that's number one, is to create a video. So number two, is that you can create a infographic from that blog content. So the web is visual, and people like to skim at things. People like to see images. You can create an infographic, and you can use a simple tool like Canva, the free online piece, tool. You can use Photoshop if you're software savvy. You could go to Fiverr and get a freelancer to do it, maybe for, you know, $30-$35, something like that, to create a infographic. And they're going to cover those 5 points, and they can give a little content. It's going to be a simplified version, and they'll add visuals to that. Then you can take that, you could add to the blog post. You could create a new blog post about the infographic, refer to the other blog post. You could load to Pinterest. Pinterest is a great place for that infographic, okay? And you say Pinterest, isn't that just for, you know, design and fashion, those type of things? No, not really. I mean, it's just, think of it as a visual search engine. There's a lot of great content on Pinterest, and Pinterest can, people will find it on Pinterest, they can click through, they get back to your website. So that's a good place to have it as well. So that was number two. We had video, we had infographic, and number three is to create an ebook. Now, you create an ebook, maybe with that blog post, or maybe you want to put two blog posts together and use them as a series to create an ebook that is about your topic. So if you had the five items about this in one blog post, and the five items about that in the other blog post, and they kind of can sync together. Now you've got the, you know, part A and part B, the 10 items that do this. What you want to do with an ebook then is use that as a lead magnet. So it's a call to action on your website using a tool like Waftio, and adding that in there so that there's like a pop-up or a widget on your site, and then people can just, you know, enter their name, email address, and then you give them access to that ebook. So it's a great way to begin growing your email list. It's a great way to move people from visitor to a potential lead that you can nurture. All right, so use your content to create an ebook and create that ebook into a lead capture tool. So that's another way you can do that. The fourth thing that you can do is to syndicate your posts. So you got that blog post. There are other platforms that are blogging platforms where you might want to use it, such as LinkedIn Publisher. So you can take a blog post and then you can publish it on LinkedIn Publisher as a post on that site. It's a specific LinkedIn blogging site. And you know, you can reference it. This version posted on such and such, which is your website URL, and then here's the post. Another one to do that on is Medium. That's another public blogging site. So that's a way that you can get more leverage out of your content. And a bonus one, I'll give you another one that you could do, and that is to turn it into a podcast. All right, so a podcast is the audio way of utilizing your content. So you just basically talk through the content that you produced in the blog post, and you know, load that in. There's many things you can do. My halftime mic podcast is syndicated so that you can get that on iTunes, and you can download it for Android. There's other pieces that, you know, that you can easily syndicate to SoundCloud and more. So those are ways to best utilize your content. It's not enough anymore just to say, I've got it created, I've shared it on social media, I'm done. You want to maximize that. So these are ways to do that. Finally, let's come back to that video piece there. And with the video, I had recommended that you create a video from a blog post. Now, what's a simple way to do that? I'm gonna give you a tool that you can do that with simply. Then this has a free version. So it's called Lumen 5, L-U-M-E-N 5. And on Lumen 5, you can enter in the URL of the blog post and you can begin to, so let's say you got those 5 points again. So it'll allow you to, you know, customize each of those 5 points into a scene, a slide within the video. You can choose from there a vast array of background images. You can add music to that, and so it's a full package then. So it kind of leads them through. Think of that as a animated video of your top 5 points with a little bit of extra commentary that is on screen. And music background within that and generates it. Now for the paid version, then you could add your logo brand at the beginning, at the end, it's called action, that type of piece, and you can download those videos. Then it's ready to go, and then you know how long it's gonna be, you can load that. When I said load that, one of the other places that I missed was that you can load a 1 minute video to Instagram as well. Don't overlook Instagram, it just continues to grow in in use in demographic breadth. So there's more 30s, 40s, 50-year-olds on Instagram than ever before going through content, and you can capture those people with your videos. So the video is working, and this is a way to turn a blog post into video and use it in multiple ways. And I already told you where you can load that. So just wanted to give you that tip today, that don't think that, you know, it's all just about blogging, but it's, you can easily create social media content in multiple ways with that blog post, do multiple things, from lead capture to YouTube channel videos to LinkedIn items, and engage your audiences on those platforms. So that's the best thing to do. So I was on with that on a phone call this morning with a client. We were talking through this piece, and you know, I think this was kind of like a new revelation. I mean, you hadn't thought about these things, and you know, that's what we do. I said, you know, and so think through that, and you think, you know, I don't have time for that. Okay, well, that's where you try to look for a team that can do that efficiently and effectively for you. So one of the things that we're going to do for this guy potentially, so we're talking through those pieces with him, that we can help make those things possible, from the writing of the content to the creation of all these other assets to the sharing of those assets out on social media. Making it doable, making it possible, making it so you can do what you do best, allowing, you know, others like us to do what we do best, and ultimately giving you that best presence online. So hopefully those tips are helpful, what you can do, and the ways that you can use that. You know, you've taken the time to write it, now utilize it and use some of the best means, which is video, that are out there today to utilize that, but also don't forget that lead capture on your website. So hopefully all those pieces are helpful, and that's what I want to cover today. So I got audio this time. That was what was important. So I'm going to leave you with that. And that'll be it for today with this Live with Mike episode. And again, if you want to come back, come on back and join me every Tuesday, 12 noon. Going to be here. Going to be doing a tip. And I'll try to leave you some notes that you can follow up on. So got the video corrected this time. And audio, you should have that. And with that, I am going to sign out. Take care. Have a great day.